Following the Sandy Hook tragedy, police departments are taking a look at how they respond to these types of situations. Action 7's Porter Wilcar spoke to the Rio Rancho Police Department and explains what they're prepared to do to better protect you. It's new at 10.
It's a reality turned into a nightmare. A shooter busts into a local school or business and starts firing.
No one is immune to the dangers of any kind of active shooter or school workplace violence.
Recently, we saw a shooter kill 20 children and 6 educators inside Sandy Hook Elementary in Newtown, Connecticut. And as tragic and downright frightening as that event was for the country, the Rio Rancho Police Department says it's ready if something similar were to happen in New Mexico.
This has brought to the forefront a lot of the concerns that we've had since and before Columbine. And so it just brings it back to reality that this kind of violence can occur in big cities or small towns.
Sergeant Nicholas Onken says Rio Rancho police officers train to enter any building that's under fire immediately.
Where ultimately the first couple of officers who arrive on the scene of a potential active shooter situation basically go into a hunting mode where they are going to look for any threats to immediate human life and resolve them as quickly and peacefully as possible.
Onken says they train every officer.
And this is not just something that SWAT teams do. This is something that every officer, every patrol officer, every traffic officer is trained in. To a certain degree, are rather secretive in what our exact techniques are going to be because we need to keep them somewhat sacred. But that is essentially the realm of it.
Rio Rancho police officers tell me they've been on heightened alert ever since the Newtown shooting, and not just for school shootings, but for shootings that could occur in any public place. Doug.
A number of police departments already changed the way they respond to shootings after Columbine.